I've said it on numerous occasions, sometimes it would have been easier if the disability was visible, because it's not. And they look like, you know, any other age, child of their age, and so it's been really hard.
Females can be affected by Fragile X syndrome, despite it being on the X chromosome and them having two, and they can be affected to a very variable degree. The most severely affected will be rather like the males, but it may be quite subtle, seemingly mild, but nonetheless very detrimental to the individual's welfare and ability to maximise their potential and their quality of life.
It is about anxiety, and it is about nerves, and it is also about ADHD. It's about, for them, you know, so much going on in their mind, and that they need to sort of stand back and stop and think, and then go ahead with whatever they're doing. And it's about trying to get those nerves in under control and understanding that those nerves are being driven by a genetic condition, and that other people do feel that, but theirs is more acute. And that it's okay.
It affects my nerves because it affects my learning. It also affects my
speech and language.
It also affects my brain because I have hypermobility.
My sister, she gets really anxious. I like to fiddle a lot. I like to moan quite a lot. Because I get annoyed with myself sometimes.
Maze these days doesn't like crowds as much, so she doesn't like going, we live near Brixton, and she doesn't particularly like going to Brixton. There's a great cinema there, and she finds the crowds overwhelming.
I don't like big crowds, because I just have a real problem with crowds.
I hide behind my mum and dad's back, because I don't want people looking at me.
Girls with Fragile X syndrome particularly my girls, are brilliant at disguising any issues.
The things that we thought were just behavioural, we then realise they're not behavioural, yeah. That's actually Fragile X traits.
Yeah. Because academically she's kind of like, I don't know, that's what expected, isn't she, I guess, in most areas, apart from maybe the maths.
Maths is not. But her reading's quite good.
Yeah, she reads really well. I think she speaks really well as well. I think she's very eloquent. And also, the sort of the art, the drama. She gets lots of praises for her dancing and stuff like that, so yeah.
What do you do on Thursday and Fridays?
Dance.
Really? Tell us a bit about your dancing. Go on, what do you dance? What styles of dancing do you do with Steph?
I do ballet, tap and
jazz.
I got my exam results and I got 3 distinctions.
You got really top marks, didn't you?
Maze doesn't really come in. I mean, she will draw, but she would never naturally want to come in and play a game with you, ever. I mean, you know, we really have to drag her out and play swing ball or make her play Monopoly with us. She's just totally disinterested. That creative mind isn't there, but it is for, you know, drawing. Soren, on the other hand, is completely different. She loves playing games. She's really uber competitive, but she does struggle with certain things. She's a really bad loser, like way off the scale bad loser.
We get lots of tears.
Yeah.
We get kind of, I've now noticed kind of the whole self-esteem stuff, they're trying to fit in.
Yeah.
But kind of not quite, and now kind of not really understanding. And it sounds a bit cliched, but not really understand some of the social nuances of girls and how girls get on, so we get lots of tears.
The biggest worry with Susan is that she's extremely vulnerable. People can so easily take advantage of her. Like with Ian, they want to please everyone to the extent of agreeing with them when they don't agree. And often it's me they tell when they don't agree, rather than tell that person, so I have to advocate for them.
I guess my one worry with Maze in particular, I think Maze is, Soren is a little more wary, is, you know, I would say, so, you know, outside of the house, about who to trust and not, and who to be wary of, you know, she sort of thinks anyone in a uniform is fine, and that's not necessarily the case. Do you know what I mean? So I don't know that if that information sort of goes in and stays enough, because we've repeated it, you know, endlessly. There are these women out there who have this underlying anxiety and nervousness, but given chances, they can function fully and they can be educated and they can go on and work and have families of their own.